Hey Knights, welcome back. It's our first Knightly News of the school year. I'm Emma Bilvato.
And I'm Hunter Christmas.
And Knightly News starts now. Don't feel like going home, but all my cash is gone. Yeah, I got nothing to do tonight. I'm passed out on the floor, up in the hotel bar. But it don't matter, cause I'm feeling fine. I'm thinking life's too short, it's passing by. So if I'm gonna go,
business is introducing our new staff members. Let's get to know them.
What's up, Knights? Have you guys seen any new teachers here at the castle? If not, here's a story on it.
Okay, I'm ready.
What school did you come from?
I came from Loma Heights Elementary School.
How do you like it here?
I love it here. I love the staff and I really enjoy my position.
And what do you do?
I am the attendance secretary for the staff and students.
I came from El Paso, Texas.
And what do you teach?
I teach English, freshmen and juniors.
And how are you liking here at Amante?
I think it's great. Everyone's really friendly, and so far the students seem really good and overall doing their work. And yeah, I think I'll be very happy here.
I taught previously at DACC, Doñana Community College.
And how do you like it here?
I like it very much. It's a very friendly community, and all the teachers are great, and everybody's just helpful.
And what do you teach?
I'm teaching AP Psychology, three sections of AP Psychology, a block of US History, and I have a caseload of 9 AES freshmen.
I used to be a Trojan, so I came from Mayfield High School.
How do you like it here?
I actually love it here. I'm really enjoying it. I like being a Knight, something different.
And what do you teach or do?
I work in the dungeon, so I do lunch detention and fun stuff like that.
That's the new staff here at Onate. If you see them around, make sure you give them a warm welcome. And you better be at the game tonight, guys. Signing off for Knightly News, this is Zach Priscelli.
Have you heard about the new electric here?
No, I haven't. Let's go check it out.
Where did you previously work?
I worked at Carlsbad High School, Carlsbad High School.
Athletic trainers work to help athletes be prepared for practice and games.
How long have you been an athletic trainer?
For 10 years. 7 years at Carlsbad and 3 years at New Mexico State University.
They also help to make sure athletes perform to the best of their ability.
What made you come to Oñate?
Great high school, great kids, great faculty. Always said that if there's one job in Las Cruces I'd ever want, it was always the Oñate spot. It came open.
Well, welcome to Oñate, Brian Blazer. I hope you have a great year here.
We have all kinds of different styles for different seasons, and the season we're in right now, summer, we have tons, so let's go check them out.
If you guys don't know, we're back in school, and there's some pretty new people looking fresh, and there's some old people with new styles. Let's go check them out.
I think I look fresh because I'm wearing a dope pineapple, and you don't see people wearing pineapple nowadays. I think I'm a good, like, 8 fly.
Why?
10 every day.
Fresh.
Because I'm iced out. Got this gold on.
I'm popular. So why do I think it's so fly?
Mm-hmm.
Just look at me, bro. Top flight security. Wait a second. That's like 3 words? Or is top flight 1 word?
I think that I try and like stay like up to date with like all the different styles. I think I am the definition of fresh.
Freshness.
There are no words to describe my freshness.
Well, those are some of the fresh people we could find around the castle. But you know, knowing some people out there, man, you guys should take some notes, really. This one was for you guys. Well, it's Christian Rodriguez signing off for the Knightly News. Have a good one.
Freshmen, this is for you. You need to learn what high school is all about.
Oh, didn't see you there. So you guys are new to the castle, huh, freshmen? Well, I got a little advice for you guys. Hey guys, here's the first advice, all right? Make sure you guys always bring your headphones and charger.
That's it, guys. No, I'm just kidding. Popularity isn't a thing anymore, all right? It's not middle school. You guys are in high school now. And, yeah, it's just really not that important. You just should focus on classes. If you're gonna be late to school, make it count, all right? If you're 30 minutes late, you're already absent. Might as well go get McDonald's before you come in, because you're already absent. There's no excuse for it. Get involved. Don't be like me, who doesn't do anything in high school and is just bored their whole high school years, all right? And, you know, just be your guys' selves, all right? Don't have to be like anybody else. Just be your own thing. This has been Jacob with some freshman advice. See ya.
Do you hear that sound? That's the sound of a car. And that means you need to get your parking sticker and your off-campus pass, if you want to go off-campus, with your car that is allowed to be on campus because of your parking sticker. It all makes sense. Well, our fall sports are approaching really quick, and with sports, come Night Center. Take it away, Night Center.
Welcome back, Knights. This is our first edition of Night Center. I'm Wendy.
And I'm Jacob.
And Night Center starts now.
I'm ready for soccer.
I'm ready for cross country.
I'm ready for volleyball.
We're ready for football!
Let's go, boys!
I'm ready for cross country.
I'm ready for soccer.
Are you ready?
All this school spirit around school has got me really hyped for tonight's game.
Here's Jade with some words from the football team.
Hey Knights, expectations are high for this year's Black Knight football team. Let's see what the coaches and players have to say about this season.
Just been preparing this off season for Centennial, and our scout team has pushed us to the max.
Got a couple games that we need to win. Got a real tough schedule this year, but I don't know. We'll see what happens, and we need y'all out there to come watch us and support us. Woo!
It doesn't matter which grade, you just gotta step up and play.
My expectations as a team captain is to do whatever I can for the team.
We're learning day by day how to get better. You know, we're knowing where assignments are, and just getting to the ball as quick as you can.
Well, you know, we got some very good leaders this year. We had the election of captains, and Luis Duarte, Everett Garibay, Forrest McKee, and James Martin were elected captains by their teammates. In addition, I think Jovan Guadian has really stepped up and worked hard and done some good things.
Our first home game is tonight at 7 at the Field of Dreams against Centennial High School. Hope to see you all there. Good luck, Knights.
Always a state and district favorite.
Let's get an inside look of this year's expectations for the cross country team.
You know, I'm very excited to what the 2015 cross country season will bring. Got an excellent group of boys and girls this year. They're working hard. They're doing the things that are necessary to be successful. You know, we got some big goals in store as far as team goals are concerned. They want to defend their district titles. They definitely want to improve their placing at state. Last year, the girls were sixth. The guys were ninth. They want to get into the top three if they can this year. I think if they continue doing what they're doing, that goal could be obtained. We got a lot of great individual runners as well that have returned, that are that are doing a great job providing some leadership for the new people that have come aboard. So I'm just very excited for what the season's going to bring.
Thomas Salas was our last year's district champ. Let's hear what he has to say.
My goals for the team this year are to place in the top three and possibly get a state championship. And my goals individually are to win state.
Our first meet is next week at Gadsden on a Friday. So it's unusual to have a cross-country meet on Friday, but it's going to be kind of something new for everybody. So we're excited bringing that part in to our season, getting to start off on a Friday, which is kind of cool. So, hey, I just got nothing but good to say about the team and what the season might bring for us. And hopefully we can represent this school in a manner that, you know, that we can all be proud of.
Sadly, we lost a lot of seniors from last year's volleyball team.
And I bet you guys are really wondering how they're going to be doing this year. Let's spike it off to Matt and Hunter.
This year's volleyball team has started off the season great and have very high expectations. Let's go talk to the team captains and Coach Bennett and see what they have to say.
The volleyball team has high expectations for this season. Let's take an inside look on what the captains have to say.
I expect us to go really far this year, especially with the hitters and the defense that we have. I would really like us to win district and qualify for state.
We definitely want to make it far and win district possibly, and then definitely make it far in the state tournament too.
The volleyball team has felt the energy from the student section, but we still need to keep it up for the rest of the season.
I feel like the student section is important at our games, and it gives off good energy and like keeps us motivated.
The volleyball team has lost 8 seniors last year, but with the help of sophomores and juniors, they still hope to make it far.
Honestly, it feels a lot different because we lost 8 seniors and they were a big part of the team, but I think we'll do just fine.
Well, last year we graduated 8 people, so when you lose 8, it's a big, you feel the difference. We've got some young players that have stepped into some pretty big shoes, and literally big shoes. We're not as big as we were, but we're almost as talented, maybe not as deep as we were last year on the block or some other things, but I think together they play just as well.
How do you think those girls play tonight?
Good.
What do we have to do to improve?
Nothing.
Good talk, thanks.
Even with the loss of leadership, these young Knights look to bounce here this year. Reporting for Knightly News, this has been Zion Allen.
That's a championship team! You see that?
Our cross country team has a Gadsden Invitational today at 3 p.m. As we all know, our football team has a game tonight at 7 against Centennial. Our volleyball team is in the Franklin Tournament, and they have games today and tomorrow.
Our boys and girls soccer team play this weekend in the LCPS Soccer Tournament.
So I hope to see you guys all out there tonight supporting our boys out there. Really need that extra support. Signing off for Knight Center, this has been Jacob.
Wendy.
And we'll see you guys next time.
OBB!
Right guys, that's a wrap. I hope you guys all enjoy the first Knightly News, and hopefully you enjoy all the other news to come.
This has been Emma Bilvato
and Hunter Christmas.
See you later.